can go ahead and get started.
The battle of legalization of marijuana is an ongoing one throughout our country. The drug marijuana and the legalization of it could have many harmful side effects and unforeseen consequences on you and your community. Although many people may have differing opinions on the matter, there is a vast quantity of information you could use to possibly make your own choice about your stance on the legalization of marijuana. In my personal experience, I felt the legalization of marijuana when my hometown of Denver, Colorado, implemented the legalization of it in 2012. It became legal in 2012 due to the passing of Amendment 64, and I remember going out that day, January 1st, 2012, and seeing thousands of people lined up to buy marijuana legally for the first time. Not only have I seen the effects of this drug in my personal life, but there are many sources that show the legalization of marijuana and the cons it can have. Dr. Wang from Colorado State University did his research and a study on hospital visits among children and teens and how they went up or down when marijuana was involved. We know that marijuana use at a young age can affect adolescent brains, says Dr. Wang. Along with the hospital visits of children and teens going up, the calls to the Poison Control Center when marijuana was involved went up from 9% in 2009 to 47% in 2015. Now, if you flip over your handout, you can see that marijuana-related hospital visits are very high, and not way higher than most things, and up next to it is alcohol. Yeah, if you can please put your handouts away. Along with hospital visits, car accidents and other accidents while people are high have also increased. Drivers who have tested positive to using marijuana has gone up 145% between 2013 and 2016, according to an article in the Denver Post. Now, these are all pretty bad things to happen since the legalization of marijuana, but there are some things being done to stop the spread of legalized marijuana. An example of this is the organization CALM. CALM stands for Students Against Citizens Against Legalized Marijuana, and it's an organization made to inform people about the dangers of it and provide them with an outlet to speak out against it. Marijuana is a mood-altering drug capable of producing dependency. While popularly thought to be a fairly benign drug, marijuana can have adverse effects on memory and learning, perception, behavior and functioning, and pregnancy, says the American Society of Addiction Medicine on the CALM website. With organizations like CALM in place, we could possibly have a marijuana-free future. Legalizing marijuana can lead to very unsafe communities and lead people to make bad choices when they're out on streets. If we, as a society, help stop the spread of it, it could lead to a better future for us and our children. With this vision of our future without marijuana in mind, what can you do to help stop the spread of this drug? Well, one thing you can do is you can join an organization like CALM and help spread the word of the danger of legalizing it and help tell people about what it can do. And if there isn't an outlet where you can join one, you could also make one, maybe at your church or at your school, get a group of people together and decide to campaign against it yourself. Now that you maybe know a little bit more about marijuana and the possible side effects of legalizing it, hopefully you can make a more informed decision for yourself. Nobody understands it and people are dying. That's a huge public safety problem, says Greenwood Police Chief John Jackson. The drug marijuana and the legalization of it can have many harmful and possibly unforeseen side effects on you and your community. Hopefully, now that you know a little bit more about it, you can make a more informed decision about your stance on the legalization of marijuana.
Thank you very much. Let's give him a round of applause. Thank you. All right. If you have questions at this time, you can go ahead and pose them for Theo.
Elijah.
I've heard people say that there have actually been no reported deaths coming straight from marijuana. So would you consider marijuana to be a deadly drug?
You're right in that there have been no deaths linked directly to marijuana. But there have been a lot of deaths that have occurred because people are high on it and do stupid things. But that can also happen with alcohol or other substances. So it could be safe to say that marijuana is a deadly drug, but it's just as deadly as alcohol is, if not less deadly, honestly. Anna?
Why should banning marijuana work any better than banning alcohol?
I mean, in theory, it shouldn't, honestly, but it... There's already a bit large black market for it, and legalizing it just made it a lot worse. So if we take away the legalized part, we can put more effort into fighting the black market part of it. But...
How easily are underage people able to get marijuana now that it's legal?
I didn't see anything on that, but in my personal experience, I've seen people like that I've gone to grade school with are able to get it very easily in their art class in high school, so I didn't see any facts about it, though. Jada?
What are the long-term negative effects of marijuana?
Long-term negative effects of marijuana, if you smoke it, it can be just like any other smoking. It can lead to lung cancer and other cancers because of carcinogens in it. But it can also cause loss of brain cells and things like that. Melina?
What were the benefits of legalizing it? Because, what reasons did the government have that were yes, this is a good thing to do?
One thing that they legalized it for was the tax money you get from it, because marijuana is taxed very heavily. So the government gets a lot of money from the taxes for that, and they can build new schools and libraries and things like that.
Okay, last question.
Kaka?
What about the people who need it for, medical purposes?
For medical purposes?
Yeah.
That has been legal for a while. I personally didn't see anything about it, and it going up or down with the legalization of recreational marijuana. But that's just what I saw.
Alrighty. Let's go ahead and give Theo a round of applause. Thank you very much.